We got the home stretch, gamers, for our last game of the day between 100 Thieves Academy and CLG Academy. We just saw 100 Thieves Academy take the first game of the series, and now CLG Academy. I mean, this is by far the toughest opponent they have played in their schedule so far, Crumbs. 100 Thieves are leading the leaderboards right now. But, I mean, every other series we've seen today was able to equalize it in a 1-1 in the series. Do we see it here for CLG Academy?
Well, depends on their draft. I'll leave it at that. Depends on their draft, because in this game, 100 Thieves did actually start at a deficit. The bottom lane from CLG ended up picking 2 kills for this first one, although it was then off the back of Ryoma and Kenvi that they then just started rolling, steamrolling this game. And here is how that actually plays out: a single teleport with an equalizer, and just watch Lee Sin. He's already 3-0, has the Gore Drinker, bam, Tempest, ooh, Gore Drinker, Flash Kick, that's 2 kills. And then the third one, yeah, he doesn't hit the Q, but in fact, it's actually pretty nice that the gold is shared, because Luger did a fantastic job with what is given to him. He's one of those hit carries that actually makes the most out of gold almost every single time he gets to play it.
Yeah, I mean, Ryoma had a fantastic game on the Lee Sin. He did die once just now as he was going for the insect on the Katsuri, but his ability to be able to stall out the fight as long as he could gave 100 Thieves Academy the ability to be able to deal with the rest of the members of CLG. And now as we're getting ready for the draft phase to begin in just a couple of minutes here, Crumbs, CLG Academy is going to be taking the blue side this time around. More than likely, we have seen Lee Sin as the first pick across the board in, I believe, almost every single game today.
I am so glad you brought up Lee Sin, because that is exactly where my head was at. Lee priority, it's just got to be there. Clearly, this pick, I think, is just getting too good right now. Players are getting much better at it. The laning phase, the play potential, every single flash, right? You've got flash, it's a kill. At least a kill. And his ability to be played to a level that I think is more than acceptable is so much higher than Akali's. Akali is so much harder to execute properly than the Lee Sin. It's clearly showing in how all it takes is a single member playing a champion that can peel, and suddenly Akali just can't get into the mix. Exhaust, right? You just exhaust the Akali and there's that. You can't exhaust Lee Sin from kicking your AD carry. Yeah, you'll diminish his damage, but the displacement is still there. And that's the kind of thing that Lee is better at guaranteeing. And I think that's why we're seeing his priority just rise so much higher.
Yeah, Lee Sin has been pretty much fantastic in all the games that we have seen today. Not only 100% pick ratio for blue side on first, but if my memory serves correctly as well, he's won almost every single game today as well. So for, you said it, Crumbs, the Lee Sin priority has got to be contested. And if CLG Academy, Tien has shown that he can play it. RGS has also shown some ability on it as well. I don't know if I've seen Keel play games, but I mean, he's a jungle that's been around for quite some time. I wouldn't put it past him, so that CLG Academy can have that three-way flex with the Lee Sin. But looking at other parts of the map and, you know, trying to identify ways that CLG Academy can find wins here, since that they're on the blue side, other things that can happen, Crumbs, if the Lee Sin priority is going to be that contested, we saw that red side actually went for both Lulu and Karma Ban because 100 Thieves knew that they were going to be content with either one. Now, I wonder if 100 Thieves are actually scared of banning those two enchanters, knowing that Lee Sin is such a hotly contested topic right now.
Yeah, here's what I think the priority should be: Karma above everything else. Give up Karma, but don't give her up with Lulu. If Lulu is up, I think you don't want to be giving up the Lulu if you can take the Karma. The problem is that you can end up losing the Zin. They can end up pairing Zin and Lulu together and deny you from having it. So I think you want to first pick the Karma if the Lulu is banned. If not, if they're both banned, then go for the Lee Sin. If all three are available, I think you can go with the Karma again. And then they'll probably have to take Lee Sin and Sin Zhao, or maybe they take Lee Sin and Lulu, and then you can deny the Sin Zhao. But if they're smart, they would take Lee and Zin, and then put you in the tough position. If are you going to really take Karma and Lulu in the same team? You say yes, and we're gonna put a Kog'Maw behind it and just try to run with it because it's a best of two, and obviously we're already past that first step. But if it were a whole series, you just need to see what the priorities are going to be. This is one area that I feel like we have yet to see teams really experiment with, is the trading of these power picks. It seems like a lot of these picks are just entirely banned. No one is giving anybody the chance to actually trade and show their hand in what they're willing to trade. And I think that's the next step in the meta right now, is seeing which priorities are worth it and which are not. One that we're already seeing seems like Lee Sin for Akali, not worth it for the Akali every time. But what about the Zin, the Lulu, the Karma? I need to know.
We're definitely going to get an answer on that once we get into the draft phase. And I wouldn't put it past 100 Thieves to be the one that say, you know what, we'll take both Lulu and Karma, because both of those picks are have been played by Ryoma and Tenacity and Poom as well across both the spring split and when we saw Poom briefly in LCS during last summer as well. So that's one of those things where it's like, normally you would expect that they would be rather just taking one of those enchanters away, but if you just get both of them, then you have two enchanters that could buff up one dedicated hyper carry for 100 Thieves Academy. And I imagine that even if the Xin Zhao is taken away from 100 Thieves, that there are still more picks that they can reach into, whether it's for the jungle or Kenvi, or whether it's for Luger in the bottom.
Yeah, and I think another one of those picks is the Braum. It's not the carries, but it's something that pairs super well with these enchanters. We've seen Cloud9 identify it. We've seen other teams, 100 Thieves, the Academy team also utilize the Braum. We've seen Taric be a pseudo Braum-esque kind of champion, really good at peel, really good at stunning people that are trying to get up and personal with you. So I think that this is another pick that pairs really well with these enchanters that is slowly rising in priority with regards to what is actually being selected by the enemy team, because it's not like Braum is amazing at all circumstances. He's just working really well when you have peel for people that want to auto attack a lot, or he's working really well against a lot of divers. But if you need hard engage and the compositions are calling for that, Braum is the last guy you want on your lineup. And so seeing the flexibility that these teams can have is going to be really exciting. They're banning the Karma, so maybe they want to go with another direction. I still think you just gotta just pick it. It's really not that hard. I mean, Rafa, we went to MSI and we saw Penta and TG play Zed with no practice, with zero practice on it that year, and still execute it, right? These guys are professional players. They've played these champions for so long. They've seen them. To me, it just says we don't want to play it, or we don't like this style, but there is so much power clearly behind it. And with the double enchanter ban, I just think they're going to get rid of Lee Sin. And 100 Thieves wants them to. You're banning Akali. CLG is happy to oblige. I'm thinking 100 Thieves responds with a Nocturne and something else.
That would be my best guess as well, since seems to be one of the few lanes that can match Lee Sin's early priority in lane. CLG Academy get their hands on the Blind Monk this time around. I'm definitely want to see what 100 Thieves Academy see as their preferred counter option. They're going to... Okay. Set Rumble.
Set does well. Set does well into the Lee Sin. Lee wants to get next to you. Well, that's exactly where Set wants you. And it goes really well with the Rumble. So they're going to have some 2v2 synergy there already. Ooh. But CLG just going with full peel. 100 Thieves, this is the opportunity to double down. Are you going full dive into this composition, or are you going to try to kite back a little bit more? I think you go full dive here and you lock in whatever you think is going to help you. But Jace is also a really strong pairing, so Jace Rumble is a classic combination. Let's see what they think about it. It's going to be Tristana, though. Still a flex.
Yeah, either Ryoma can take it for himself in the mid lane, or can go to Luger in the bottom lane. With Tristana, you gain siege potential thanks to your ability to place explosive charges onto the turret. And you have reset potential, and you have a lot of burst, thanks to her combo with her spells. So being able to pair that with the Rumble as well, we're looking for 100 Thieves Academy to just try and be able to just get these resets to allow her to Goomba Stomp all over these fights. CLG Academy already have a lot of protection, though. You have this Lee Sin for disengage, and then Senna Tom Kench is already a very, very difficult lane to try and shut down, for lack of a better term, Crumbs, because every time I've seen teams try to gank a Senna Tom Kench, it does not end well.
And especially if you're trying to pair a Nautilus here with the Rumble, which is the classic combination between support and jungle, because you can just devour whoever gets actually hit by that death charge. So it does make things trickier for 100 Thieves, and Senna is a bit more powerful now that people are going with the Divine Sunder as a build. And so instead of singling out a single target with the Nautilus, it will be the AoE of the Rel. So this can be just as devastating as the Nautilus, but it has a higher burden of execution as it is not a point and click guaranteed. It will depend on Poom finding the angles, flashing in, and getting the right targets.
Heal was able to use the Xin Zhao in the prior game, but he's actually going to dip into the Udyr for going into game two. You want a little bit more guaranteed crowd control, just being able to run around in team fights, bear slap people, stun them for a bit. CLG Academy, you know, with quite a bit of options for RJS, as it looks like they are just trying to figure out who they're gonna be their last solo laner here. This would be interesting. Okay, yeah.
Blind Ziggs. Go Zed, Ryama. Go Zed and put an end to it. and end it right there. Go Zed. Don't give him a chance.
That would be spicy. We're at 10 seconds on the clock here, 100 Thieves Academy.
It's not Senna mid, right? It's clearly going to be... Oh, okay. It's going to be Tristana in the mid. So just an AD to shove him in. I guess they're committing to the Tristana already. They don't want to go with anything crazy here, but... Yeah, it's a Ziggs, except there's not a lot of setup. There really isn't much setup here for the Zig. And against Tristana, she's going to be fine. She's going to be having a grand old time against Ziggs, just dodging away from his bombs because she keeps a long range. So she doesn't need to be auto-attacking these melee creeps at melee distance. She can keep her distance. So the laning phase will be nice and easy, and CLG is just going to be counting on peeling back, except their comp doesn't have a lot of mobility or peel. It's just Tom Kench and Lee kicking a few members, but none are actually in that much danger. Between Luger, Tenacity, and Kenvi, there's not enough peel to protect these carries.
Now, CLG Academy, they will have to rely on a little bit of the terrain control that Ziggs can offer with the explosive minefield, but... still, you got to get to that point, as if he doesn't have enough damage, then the explosive minefield isn't going to be that much of a threat for 100 Thieves Academy, as you're going to be scaling that skill in second. So you need to hit at least the level 13 mark before it start doing, or it will do some major work in these mid-game fights. As 100 Thieves, they have plenty of range with Tristana and Varus being able to poke and siege safe distances away, and they have ways to be able to peel back and disengage as well, thanks to Magnastorm, Showstopper, and even throwing down an Equalizer to cut off routes of escape or engage.
Okay.
That is aggressive.
Yeah, I guess they're just hoping maybe a single member was there running around, but you wonder what scrims might have looked like if this is the prepared plan where maybe there's a chance that CLG has a five-man stack on try and suddenly Tristana jumps into five members, but enough for fantasy. This is just going to be Ryoma starting with the rocket jump because she doesn't need explosive shot early on to damage her CSing. So it all works out in the end. 100 Thieves just go on a reconnaissance mission and, in fact, get a red ward on the red buff of CLG. So it actually pays off in the end for them.
Wow, just level one right off the gate. Katsuri has to respect the engage potential from Poom and Luger, but now Hooks Gonna try to turn around the Ives of Battle. Poom having to flash away as he's dismounted. They're just turning it right around. Katsurian hooks. Second time around that they have been able to turn around a 2v2 isolated and results in a couple summoners being burned.
These solo laners, in fact, everybody is just hunting for blood here. They have had enough of waiting around. They just want to kill each other. Every single matchup looks to be going for all lanes after all lanes, but CLG's in the bot side is going to win it out just because they have heals. So they deter the initial engage and can now keep themselves safe and making sure that nobody can actually go after them. Although Rumble is pathing down, so we're about to have our first little bit of action. Udyr is not close, but he is in the red quadrant.
RGS just trying to disengage himself as we do see Kemvi was approaching the lane, but Poom and Luger do need to be able to set up Kemvi since apart from slows on the electric harpoon, which I don't think he actually has access to since he's maxed 2 points into his flame spitter at the moment and then the shield for second ability. Can't really assist much in terms of gank strength. You would just have to rely on Luger and Poom being able to get Katsurian hooks to overextend.
Does have them now, and Keel is in the bot side fighting for a scuttle, so CLG's bot lane should be first to move, but Tristana is moving in the mid lane, so I think that Kenvi actually ends up winning out on this scuttle crab, and might be able to even two crab Keel out of this.
Oh, that would be massive, especially considering that you're playing against an Udyr who has a much easier time of being able to secure those crabs. Is oh, that's a beautiful satchel charge. They're just going to flash right onto Ryoma, but he has Kemvi right there in the wings, and there's a teleport coming in from Tenacity. Facebreaker comes out. Keel still doesn't have flash from before.
Oh!
Tenacity trying to commit. Oh, but Tenacity knows that he went way too far forward, and Tien with an answer of his own, and the teleport finds Ryoma on the back end of it.
CLG get 2 kills out of that one. They get the crab in the end. But 100 Thieves, they thought they were baiting. They thought they had the kill with Tenacity's teleport ready to go, with Kenvi in the back just waiting for Keel to flash. They saw that Keel was intent on flashing, but the thing they did not anticipate there was the face rush proc. He parked that, they engaged onto him the second that happened, so not only did the harpoon do less, he was able to speed away so fast. So let's take a look at this one, because you can watch Kenvi just waiting in the corner, knowing that they're going after Ryoma after the satchel charge. And so when Keel is flashing in here, he does not get slowed at all. And Kenvi is already overheated, his cooldowns are down. So by the time Tenacity goes in here, even commits the haymaker perfectly in the middle. No damage, nothing but to stand and accept his fate like a good samurai.
Tenacity definitely tried. He committed for that one. And Keel saying, well, good attempt, buddy. Not enough. He's giving him the thumbs up emoji as well. Ryoma, despite the death, is still pressing forward with his advantage over RGS.
And it's the power of Tristana. Just being able to constantly all in, as long as she's procking her explosive shot, her rocket jump will be on a shorter cooldown than the satchel charge. So that's what RJS has been using to deter her this whole time. But the windows where Ryoma has it available is when he looks to go for it. He needs to have the jungle nearby, though, because he's going to be susceptible to another gank like that if he keeps doing this every single time.
So from TM being able to dodge out on the almost max stack of the Haymaker, Tenacity having level 6, but both the junglers on the bottom side of the map, so it's still just the two homies in the top lane, whereas 100 Thieves trying to go for this dragon. Hooks did go for a reset. This is an opportune time to get it as RGS. Uh-oh, the satchel charge. Woo! That's a lot of damage from Tommy.
Yeah, the satchel charge was a bit misplaced there against the wall, but he's still going to be able to last six safely. Poom has flash and ignite, though, but he does get spotted out by Keel, so there's no attempt on RJS here. Instead, it's just going to be Udyr clearing out the control ward, and Poom having to back off after being slightly annoyed.
Being a nuisance in the jungle. First dragon going over to 100 Thieves Academy, as Ryoma still being able to get the push down, starting to net a bit of a CS advantage against RJS's Ziggs. Ryoma getting potentially chased down here, baiting for Kenvy to come back up, but the control ward comes out, and Akil says, all right, never mind. I'm going to go back in. Still dancing, though, trying to keep them in as long as possible. Tien getting engaged on with the Showstopper Tenacity, trying to close the gap, but Dragon's Rage was used to disengage as Kiel is in the area. Kenvy's falling behind as well. Trying to ward hop, but the Equalizer clips him, and the Haymaker's enough to take down Tien. Kiel, you gotta run away, buddy.
Really well played there by Tenacity, utilizing his cooldowns wisely, making sure that he doesn't put himself in harm's way when Lee Sin has his safeguard available. And now with the Rumble helping him out, he gets a kill, gets to crash the wave, and Tien misses out on all that precious farm. So top lane going very nicely, 400 views, as the rest of the solo lanes are just farming away. And if they can continue to have a place to build their synergy between Set and the Rumble, this is the duo that can win team fights with a grand slam when we get to those Dragon 5v5s.
100 Thieves Academy still able to find some advantages despite the disastrous opening CLG Academy as, oh, okay, nice patience from Poom, being able to get the repel stun onto Katsurian. Ryoma's there for the cleanup. Does he have Buster Shot? Explosive Charge might be enough, but Ryoma is going to go down, taking a little too long on being able to get the kill for the reset, but Hook's also falling to Luger.
It is not a safe lane. The Senna and the Tahm-Kench might have their summoners up, but there is so much damage and crowd control between the 100 Thieves members. They didn't even use the Magna Storm there from Boom, and so Luger with his Chains of Corruption is enough to keep them locked down, let the rest of the team collapse, get a few kills, get a plate. It will come at the cost of this Rift Herald, but it is being known that it is being done. So Kenvy is collapsing. Tenacity has ultimate and equalizer, so this is going to be a fight.
Now Smite secures the Rift Herald for CLG Academy. Kiel's able to pick it up, and the Phase Rush and the Flash says, zoom, zoom, zoom. He's out there like Naruto, baby.
He is so fast. That is ridiculous, actually. Every time he procs that, I thought that spell got nerfed. Just seeing it now in the current iteration and thinking this is like half as weak as it was before is pretty bonkers. So let's see how this play went down right away, because you stun the Senna, but then double stun afterwards, and then she's already low. Here comes Luger, though. The rest of the team is ready to follow up, and there isn't even any need or the Tendrils of Corruption at the end. He shoots them right afterwards. Rel is more than enough, and we see why she selected into the Senna and the Tahm-Kench. She actually just stuns them when she gobbles them out.
This is nicely done from Poom, being able to wait on the release of the Devour before committing the Attract and Repel. As you pointed out, 100 Thieves Academy, slowly but surely, starting to claw their way back in terms of a gold deficit. Now they have evened it up across the board. So far, no mythics have been completed for any of the players on the Rift here. But tier 2 boots being completed for various members means that their mobility and their ability to rotate to certain parts of the map will be that much faster.
Tier 2 boots are some of my favorite kinds of items when you're trying to make an action-packed game. Just allow everybody to not only get into the fight faster, but die and get into the fight faster. That's pretty much the story behind Tier 2 boots. Obviously, the value behind each individual bonus is great, but the mobility is often overlooked.
Uh-oh. RGS might be... Oh, beautiful collapse from Kenvy, but Tien with the safeguard. He's able to save his teammate's life. RGS, I thought it was dead to rights.
Yeah, Katsuri with the Fates Call, or sorry, with the Senna ultimate also being able to keep the Stigs alive, but the fight don't stop.
We got the Devourer, but Poom, once again, waiting for the Devourer to be done before committing his ultimate ability with the Magna Storm collapsing and punishing. Katsuri goes down. 100 Thieves Academy continue to extend their lead.
We're really... Oh, Ryoma. He's got a rocket jump, though. It should be fine.
Well, Kiel does have quite a bit of damage, and he does rocket jump to the safety of his friends, who are now here. Kiel was looking to throw down the Rift Herald in the mid lane and knock down the first brick, but doesn't get the opportunity to.
Okay, now he's still looking around in the mid lane, but he will get spotted by this control ward. I was really curious why Ryoma didn't use a second instance of rocket jump onto RJS. I thought that would have been able to get them a kill onto the Ziggs. Must have thought that They had enough burst, and can you blame him though? Katsuri's ultimate was really quick and clutch there, coming out from nowhere. And on top of that, Lee Sin coming down from the mid lane, there's a lot of things that were unexpected that kept RJS alive.
Mid lane turrets are quite the hot topic right now. Tenacity getting that shove in was looking potentially for a play. We'll get spotted out in the river as Katsuri still trying to hold RJS's hand to make sure that he doesn't get absolutely collapsed on. Hooks is here as well. It's about to be a whole party. They know that Poom is on this ward, but Kiel engaging right in, just not respecting the damage as he just wanted to throw down the Rift Herald right in front of the turret. And Ryoma and Kenvi, do they have what it takes to be able to burn the Rift Herald before it gets a crash down? They throw down the Equalizer, but Tien is going to be here first for the roam. Tenacity still over on the top side of the map. He has teleport available if they want to commit it. And between the Satchel Charge and the Rift Herald, the first brick is secured for CLG.
All right, that looked kind of weird, seeing Kiel just go so close just to pop that Rift Herald. But the fact that the rest of the team backed him up to ensure that the play went through made it all right at the end. Now, the Dragon is available, and teams will have to reset. But with a newly taken mid lane turret from CLG, they can feel much more confident about this Dragon fight, as they can just base, and they can know that they can shove out for mid priority much deeper than 100 Thieves. And if they can just keep them away and make sure that the bombs and the minefields can stop them from entering the Dragon through the critical chokes like the Banana Brush or the Blue Side Ramp, then it becomes so much easier to play Ziggs.
First Mythic of the game has been secured for a few members of CLG Academy. Fordrink, Crossfire Gauntlet, and Lunas, all for the top three members for CLG. The second Dragon of the game is a Mountain One, and 100 Thieves are getting ready to contest it. Kiel is on the opposite side of the map. 100 Thieves Academy should be able to burn this down without any answer from CLG.
No one's coming. It's not really close, actually. Even Katsuri, based simply for the Sheen, I believe, and so CLG just gives up the Dragon, and 100 Thieves is happy to continue the push. Now, the plates have gone down, so it's not like it's going to cost much more gold. But if it costs turrets, then that's going to open up Poom to just be roaming around the map even further, to let their AD carries by himself, as we've seen he likes to do, and Ruger can really take care of himself.
Equalizer goes down on the hooks. Katsuri trying to do his best to make sure that they don't get engaged upon, but Poom using the Magnet Storm and the Attract and Repel to close the distance while being CC'd. He's able to secure hooks as a kill for 100 Thieves Academy, and they continue pushing their aggression further into the jungle of CLG.
That looked like such a casual move going after hooks, as he's just trying to waddle out of there. Already had the Merc Treads, but he's just in a bad position as the rest of 100 Thieves gets to go over the wall and really just lock him down despite the Merc Treads. He's got so much CC that he has to deal with. They're trying to answer a Herald, though.
Yeah, it's 1,500 health on the Rift Herald. They push him away, and thank you for the leash, because 100 Thieves and Academy squad are able to take away the Rift Herald that CLG had just started up, but now they're going to try to look for the re-engage. There's no Equalizer. There's no Buster Shot available. Poom does have Flash, but he doesn't have Magnus Storm to get up. He just gets mounted up, but they close the distance, and Kiel will be able to set up Katsuri for a revenge and a shutdown.
That's a really good kill that CLG needed if they were going to stay in this game. Getting a shutdown, going over to the Senna, and yes, they lost that Rift Herald, but it's not the end of the world when you can get shutdown gold, when you have a Senna, when you have a Ziggs that will contribute to the late game. So the Rift Herald is a minor thing that was already lost from their prior mistake in the bot lane. It's salvaging that is exactly what they needed, because the gold is being distributed to the only members that can get them out of this pickle. It's gonna have to be entirely the carries, because Kiel, Tien, and even the hooks just won't have the damage to deal from the range or the tankiness that Tenacity, Poom, and the rest of the carries will bring out from 100 Thieves.
Two Dragons still an advantage for 100 Thieves Academies, who can get a quick look at the gold charts across the board. Shoutouts to our awesome observers for doing that. You can see that slight gold lead for Tenacity in the top lane, and it just kind of dispersed all around the map. But main advantage that we're looking at is really this mid lane. RGS, despite, you know, being pressured by Ryoma earlier on in the game, has been able to pick up so much farm and so much turret plating gold thanks to the Rift Herald play that we saw, as Hooks trying to defend this turret from falling, but he's not going to get a chance to.
Yeah, that's going to be another turret. It's going to be only the mid lane turret, but a dive onto bot.
Yeah, they just kick out Tenacity after using the Showstopper. Doesn't even get a chance to use the Haymaker. It's just an easy kill for CLG.
Now, what can 100 Thieves get out of this one? Because there is a Rift Herald available on Kenvi. It won't get the mid-tier 2. Ryoma 1v2-ing.
Well, I mean, he's trying to do the 1v2, but Katz, you're in RGS. You can't disrespect the damage at this point of the game. He has the Divine Sunderer, and he's got the range to be able to track you down. Kenvi was just not there. Be able to assist Ryoma in that is a little too aggressive. And Tien? Oh, okay.
Oh, he's fine. He's fine. That was a really good satchel charge out of RJS in the mid lane fight that caught Ryoma. I think that's a surprising him. It's been really well timed every single instance we've seen it, where either Tristana is going in, her rocket jump is being interrupted by it, or it's just keeping her way too close to the danger of Senna and Ziggs, and so that catches him off guard, and it's now 1-3 on the Tristana, while the carries of CLG are getting more and more gold. If Keel and Tien can take down Tenacity on the side lane, and the 2v2 of RJS and Katsuri when they group up are getting kills, it's a great sign for CLG to try to maintain these lanes and keep matching those. Keep the Ziggs in the mid lane and keep Lee Sin following Tenacity.
A quick scan of the map. 30 seconds before the next dragon of the game spawns. It's an infernal map this time around. A lot more damage would be very nice and useful for either team, as both have massive poke in one or two of their carries here. As 100 Thieves Academy are trying to wrestle for control. Oh my god, Facebreaker into the Equalizer. A lot of damage on the Katsuri and Keel, chunking them to about halfway. Mega Inferno Bomb answers back, tries to get some chunk damage down onto Poom, but Kenvi closes the distance onto Katsuri, takes him down with Flame Spitter. They're going to be able to wrestle for control of this mid lane. There do have to be a couple of recalls in for 100 Thieves members, but Ryoma, he's just pushing away on this top side of the map.
100 Thieves sees an opportunity and they instantly take it, teleporting now into the fight. There's no equalizer, but Tenacity still has the ultimate. CLG is chunked in half. They're trying to re-engage, but they're too late. Dragon is already taken.
Oh, man.
But Tom Kench is going in by himself?
He gets the tongue lash. He gets a slow, but it's just a buster shot away to be able to say, hey, we're done fighting. We don't want to fight. We already got what we came for. 100 Thieves Academy, they're now on soul point.
They saw that Katsuri was by himself without the Tom Kench in the river. So it was an easy commitment for them to go and use more ultimates to go onto the Senna, even Kenvi flashing over the wall to seal the deal on Senna's fate was everything they needed. Without her, this front line is so easy to kill. There's no heals, there's no increased damage from the backside from the Divine Sunderer on the Senna. And so taking down Senna when TK was MIA is a great opportunity for them, and it actually ended up even taking Hooks' flash, as I believe he tried to either flash save him at the very end or even flash tongue link Kenvi and see if he could prevent him from getting out.
Unfortunately, Crumbs, it was not enough to save his ADC. Push being fought for from 100 Thieves as they are not yet able to take down this first tier turret in the mid lane, which has been preventing them from being able to walk further into the jungle completely. Most of it has just been thanks to the advantages they garnered on the top side of the map, taking down two turrets and then one turret on the bottom side of the map. But now with the resources and the members slowly closing in from both sides, Equalizer is going to come out. They're just trying to force them away from the turret so they can finally take it down and now walk away. But a teleport flank coming in from the backside. It is Tien. He could look for a massive kick. Whoa! Beautiful stuff from Tien, being able to kick Ryoma through three members. They take down Kenvi, but CLG Academy, now they have to be on the run as Tenacity will be able to trade his life potentially for Keel, for Katsuri. And now 100 Thieves Academy, they might feel confident about being able to take a second winded fight off of this one. Tien goes down in exchange for Tenacity, but it's just Hooks and RGS. And 100 Thieves Academy are going to be able to turn the numbers in their favor. My goodness, what a fight.
These fights are getting really close. So many critical abilities are used, and more importantly, members that don't have flash are being picked on. Katsuri without his flash just can't do much. Without Tenacity having his ultimate missing, he could just get jumped on. It's so easy to go after the Senna when he gets on top of him, when he gets to just circle from the backside. And that whole thing started even with Tien actually having a really nice kick and eliminating the Rumble, but that wasn't even enough. The carries from 100 Thieves have so much damage, and even Tenacity is going for just a damage build thus far, so he really hurts.
Oh, Kenby might get routed off here. Hooks with the collapse thanks to the Abyssal Voyage. Ryoma's going to try to get in there, use the Buster Shot to peel away some of the members here, but the Equalizer comes out a little too late. CLG Academy, they've got the slows, they got the stuns to be able to lock down Kenvi, and Baron is up on the table. No jungler to contest for Smite as well. CLG Academy might look to flip right here.
They can stay healthy with the Senna, but they don't have a lot of damage. That's the big trouble. RJS has to use his poke. 100 Thieves is poised to take this fight.
Watch Tien. Does land the Resonating Strike on the Tenacity. That's not the target that he wants, though. Wants to look for Ryoma, wants to look for Luger, as those would be juicy targets to set up for a kick. But 100 Thieves Academy still having enough pressure to be able to poke the members of CLG. And as you said before, Crumbs, they just don't have enough damage to be able to burn down this Baron.
Yeah, they tried, but 100 Thieves quickly responded. And so that's one situation where you wonder, could they have done more or something else with the pick on the jungler, because now they actually reset at the same time as 100 Thieves, and so what should have been an opportunity for them to maybe just reset right away and get an advantage on the map that 100 Thieves couldn't take just ends up being null. And while it was just a single kill that gets some gold, the overall advancement of the game doesn't really benefit CLG, so they're gonna have to regroup and try again for this next dragon fight, as it's gonna be in 30 seconds, and so no longer can they focus around Baron. It'll have to be around this objective. You do not want to be giving a Infernal Soul against picks like Rumble or Varus. The poke will be unbearable.
Yeah, as soon as you lay down an Equalizer, that is half HP, just instantly gone. Arrow from Luger, half HP on from a squishy member, either in RGS or Katsuri. So, but Ryoma is actually forcing CLG's hand here, as he's going to be threatening inhibitor structures. CLG Academy do find Tenacity. The teleport is going to come out from Ryoma as well. They're getting a lot of damage down. Equalizer is burning Hooks to a crisp before he flashes over the wall, and Ryoma now gets the free reign to Goomba Stomp everyone as he finds Keel. Tien managing to find a shutdown onto Luger, but can you deal with the Tristana that is about to just rocket jump away and on to victory?
Oh.
Boom, following up with a Magna Storm a little too late. This is a little too far on that one. And 100 Thieves Academy, even up the odds, but it's still 2-on-2. CLG Academy not going down yet. There's no jungler for either team here, Crumb, so they could really flip for this dragon.
The CLG carries can stay healthy. They just need to know where Tenacity is at. If he gets a stun, and he's about to... Oh, they saw him.
They find him. Stridebreaker, Ryoma with the follow-up. Katsuri is gonna go down, but a nice bomb from RGS clips Ryoma mid-flight, as Tenacity still healthy enough to be able to deal with this dragon. Keel is on the map. Hooks is on the map as well. They have Abyssal Voyage. They're going to try to threaten and see if they can catch up Tenacity before he recalls.
Oh, they got the Udyr right in here. This is definitely going to beat their dragon, but not without a fight. 100 Thieves has Kenvi and Luger just beelining, and it's straight for this objective, and their ults are up.
Kenvi is running into it. Tenacity's trying to get vision. 3,000 health. Equalizer comes down, Tien just kicks him away. They try to burn down the dragon, and they're going to deny Infernal Soul away, but can 100 Thieves clean up the mess? Can CLG Academy get out? And Hooks, he's definitely not the ones being able to escape here for 100 Thieves Academy. They rout off the rest of the members of CLG Academy, but doesn't seem like there's an opportunity to take the Baron off the back end of it.
They got the Infernal Dragon, so they delay the Soul a little bit more. They're going to have to take another fight in a few minutes. That's a win for CLG. I think their carries are getting very strong. The Ziggs in particular is starting to really hurt. No one has bomb magic resistance. The best they can do is that locket from Poom. But other than that, when he goes down, they are just getting mauled. So look at Katsuri and RJS. Those are the key targets that 100 Thieves is going after. The damage that CLG offers in the dive is really not that much. The kick Yeah, it combos Luger, and yeah, he goes down, but the rest of the 100 Thieves carries have another Tristana. It's not a big deal. You've got another AD carry. And so while they win this fight, when Poom then goes a little bit in too deep, as Ryoma cannot follow through the mines, then they really start to lose these fights.
And it wasn't quite the Magma Storm as he already used it in the fight earlier on. It was just the particle from Katsuri's W locking him down for the CC. 100 Thieves Academy, like you said, don't get to claim and secure the Infernal Soul quite yet. They'll be up again for the taking for 3.5 minutes. But Baron is now the objective to play for his Keel. Uh-oh, Magma Storm. Tractor Repel, Stun, Keel, Burning Down, Flash Out. He has got the Phase Rush, and he's going to be able to make it out alive. Poom is actually on sub-10 HP, and Hook's flashing in to make sure that he can get there. And now the rest of the members of CLG Academy, though, RGS is gone, Katsuri is gone, just in the blink of an eye. I didn't even get a chance to see how that happened, but all I can tell you now is that Tien, okay, being able to answer back, takes down Ryoma before he's able to make his escape route. It's Kenvi, Tenacity, and Luger left. Between those three, they might be able to burn down this Baron.
That's a big pick, but Keel just ran straight from Baron to the bot wave. 100 Thieves saw him, so now they're just going to start this objective. They probably would have a hard time taking the 2v3 on the side of CLG, but the Q was so easy. Keel was in the bot side, just farming a wave. Now Tien will have to pull another one of these really sick plays for them to actually win this fight.
3,000 health on the Baron Tenacity. They have to turn to make sure that Keel doesn't force a 50-50 smite. Keel's burned down, and now they can turn heads right onto the Baron and secure it. But now, can they get out? Tien is going to try to clean up one. Kick onto two people through more, but Poom is here for the re-engage. But we're about to have some supports coming in for the play. Hooks and RGS have Abyssal Voyaged in. Mega Infernal Bomb, it goes wide as they all just peel away, but Kenvi will have to bite the dust here as the Sacrificial Lamb. The rest of the members of 100 Thieves Academy do make it out.
They get a few Barons off the 100 Thieves members, but at the end of the day, 100 Thieves has won that earlier fight, secured the objective, and will be able to ride this Baron out until the next dragon. So it's a win for them, but these fights are getting so close. The gold is neck and neck. 4,000 at this stage doesn't seem to matter. It's just who is a threat, and the big deal now is these top laners. Keel, at the start of this fight, face checking, is instantly about to go down, but the root on Poom prevents him from going back. So then Hooks gets to overextend, going for the kill onto Poom, and in the meantime, Tenacity obliterates the backline, single-handedly taking down RJS and Katsuri, both carries. They're lucky that Tien was able to get a kill onto Ryoma there, otherwise that would have been a whitewash from 100 Thieves.
This squad for CLG Academy have been doing their damnedest. They are almost even in kills, which is quite remarkable considering that this is the number one Academy squad, but Jesus! Tommy! This is the second time we've seen him just isolate RGS and eliminate him from the game. You saw it in game one when he was on the Lee Sin, and now we're going to see more action. Poom with the beautiful engage. Magna Storm's going to follow up. Katsuri Ryoma has the rocket jump to follow up as well. Kenvi being able to burn everyone down with this beautiful equalizer that just sets the tone and the pace for how this game from 100 Thieves Academy has been playing out. And with numbers strong, they might not even need to wait for the Infernal Dragon as they will burn down the inhibitor turret and the inhibitor as well. Five members strong, they've got what it takes to end the game and the series.
There's no wave clear. CLG need to fight if they want to hold a chance.
Tien goes in, Ferromancy, Lancer's back, and they're gone! 100 Thieves Academy, we had 100% win ratio on the blue side out of all the games today, but 100 Thieves Academy will end that streak, and they will take a home another 2-0 clean series against CLG Academy.
This team is now 9-1, having dropped only a single game to last spring's champion, Cloud9. They are on fire this split. They're looking really good, and they're going to be playing up against better and better competition that keeps looking into how they're playing. They continue to rise above the teams below them in their play, in their innovation inside the game, and so I'm really excited to see what this 100 Thieves lineup can actually come up with. because they're one of the teams that has been priding themselves on the development of talent, having moved up so many members so quickly. Really nice three-man kick there out of Tien in the back of this replay, but that just was not enough when their own carries are getting mowed down from this set. We see why this set is so prioritized. It's in the LPL that we see it a lot. The set as an answer to the Lee Sin. We see now when one goes for the insect, well, so can he.
And then the rest of the members for 100 Thieves Academy, they just had great follow-up, great ability to be able to engage. And even in the 80 carries, Luger doesn't have that much protection for himself, but because Ryoma is on this Tristana, he has the ability to Buster Shot threats away. He has the ability to rocket jump to safety and then being able to re-engage as well. And this will give credit to CLG. They did have some nice answers, and being able to almost keep up with the number one Academy squad here in the summer split so far. So it goes to show that, you know, maybe against some other opponents, CLG will look to have better numbers, as, you know, speaking with many of their coaching staff, they are very confident in their ability to be able to, you know, continue improving. But so far, 100 Thieves, by far and away, the best team that we have in the league right now.
Yeah, I wouldn't go far and away. I think they're close. I got to see against Cloud9 again. Maybe EZ could take some games. They're looking good. They're looking really clean. But I think the competition is tight. It's what we talked about earlier. The league is just getting better. It's just getting more exciting. And so there's going to be more teams contesting for that spot. And that's what you love to see, because that gives us the best quality of games. And some of these are just getting really bloody, but they're at the same time allowing these individual players to shine. So many members are having their spotlight moments just from more games, from a meta that allows them to have higher skill expression. And that is them making a case for why they're so good.
Yeah, and for all these players, just being able to quadruple the amount of games compared to what we got in Spring Split is a huge blessing. But we have for our Verizon post-match interview coming right up for one of the winners from 100 Thieves Academy. We're going to have to see who is coming on in. Oh my goodness, it is Poom Gang himself.
Hey, what's up?
We didn't see any Thresh games from you, brother, but you did put them in the Magna Storm on that rel.
Yeah, I mean, Thresh is not like super pro pick right now in the support role, so it's pretty good, but
yeah.
Is it the champs to play?
Now, well, what's in the water there in the 100 Thieves compound? Seems like the whole 100 Thieves League of Legends teams are just going in different, just taking off out of nowhere. Is there something that you guys have done in the off season, like new training methods, like something's going on? Are you guys just believing in each other? What's happened?
Yeah, I think it's just building confidence with your teammates and fighting together. I think that was, like, at least for the Academy roster, it mainly came from me. I think I wasn't playing with Kenvi very well, which I think, like, is a super important, like, duo combo. Like, jungle and support should be, like, together, like, going around the map and fighting. So I think, like, during the off season and during, like, the new beginning of the season, like, we've been practicing a lot of that. So
yeah,
there's definitely more fights happening. Yes. Sometimes the fights aren't too good, but it's more learning than not fighting.
Nice.
It definitely makes sense. I mean, you look at, you know, some of the best teams in history and where a lot of their strength came from. I mean, I think of Samsung White back in Season 4, Dandy and Motto being able to run the Rift together during their prime. And now for you, Poom, 100 Thieves Academy have been dominating the charts here for the Academy season. But, you know, or from your perspective, or maybe your teammates' perspectives, you know, who are the maybe two other teams that you're looking at that could potentially challenge your current dominating run right now?
I think of C9. I'm not sure. I'm not really sure. I mean, I think they were definitely stronger as of right now. I think player-wise, like, everyone has potential. I mean, any team has the potential to, like, contest at least top three. It just depends on, like, the growth of the team and the growth of the players. So I only think of C9. I'm not sure about the other teams, to be honest.
Now, Do you think the league has gotten better, like the quality of academy games, or is it just getting best of twos or something? Because when I'm looking at these games, I feel like the academy teams are actually improving at a pretty rapid pace. Even the teams at the bottom are putting in much of a fight. Do you feel like your whole team and the league as a whole that you're participating is actually improving?
Yeah, I definitely see like improvements from everyone. Like I think having best of twos is really helpful. Even if it would be like best of threes, to be honest, like, I mean, it's kind of the same thing, but having more games in the season just like lets you try more stuff, you know. It lets you like be more aggressive, and even if you lose a game, like, you still have another game to play. Like, it's not over. So it's definitely like better on the mental of a lot of people, and it's better like for the gameplay of a lot of people.
That's key. Better on the mental.
I like that. And before I let you go, Poom, I've got one last question for you on behalf of the caster desk here. You know, you spoke a little bit about, you know, struggling to work with Kenvy, but now you're starting to dial in that synergy a lot better. Are there any other teammates that you feel like on your roster has improved immensely since the spring split that you want to kind of celebrate?
I mean, we've all improved a lot from the spring split. I think we learned a lot, like, throughout the PG circuit. I think we learned a lot. As a team, and even like this new, like, it's kind of a meta shift, and I think, like, you know, like, Tenacity doesn't have to play like tanks anymore. And I think, you know, like, this adds a lot of like aggression to our team, you know, like, because I think as a players, individual players, we all have really good mechanics, and you know, like, I think like not being on tanks and being able to have like multiple lanes to play towards is really good as like for a team. But I think our whole team is doing really good.
Yeah, I definitely know from experience that Milan is not a fan of playing tanks in the past. So being able to
pretty good at the tanks, yeah. But
I know. Yeah. I mean, that's the surprising thing. It's like, I mean, there's a reason why, you know, we're putting you on Ornn duty in the past. You are pretty good at it, man. But you know,
yeah. Set is tank and carry. You found the middle.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly.
There you go. All right. Well, Poom, thank you so much for joining us here in the post-match interview. Go ahead and celebrate with your teams on this dominating 2-0, and we'll see you tomorrow on the broadcast.
Thank you.
Woo! Well,
all right.
No 1-1s this time, Crumbs. The curse or the streak was broken in our Academy Series run today, but 100 Thieves just continuing to extend that lead further and further here.
I am not surprised. If there would be a team to defy trends and logic, it would of course be counter logic. So all is well in the world of League of Legends.
Well, as expected, you know, CLG did have a very tough opponent, and we did kind of note that the odds were against them, but I do want to give credit that they had some nice answers and some nice plays, as you already mentioned before, Crumbs. The overall individual play and level of the Academy starting to step up, so it is leading towards an exciting rest of the summer here for Academy. And the best part of it all, we're going to get a playoffs at the end of the season, so the top six teams, I believe that will be qualifying, will get a chance to continue showing what their skill is like and how the rest of the league has improved. But for today, week three, day one, all of our games have ended, folks, so thank you so much for joining us on a spectacular set of banger games back to back to back. We hope you all had a good time, and we will see you same time tomorrow, 4 p.m. ET, 1 p.m. PT, here on twitch.tv/academy, and make sure you're catching all the other games over on twitch.tv/nerdstreetlol, and we'll see you tomorrow. Have a good night.